I'd like to bring up this question of your regional forecast of jobs, population, and housing, which is a part of the plan. And while you've provided some valuable information with great detail about the percentages of people moving here or there and who lives at home or how far miles people commute, the key finding, I think, of Plan Bay Area is that by your own studies, you're predicting that this plan hollows out the middle class. And what you show in your own diagram is that from 2010 to projecting to 2040, instead of a bell-shaped curve that would show a healthy economy and social and educational and family and a recreational kind of lifestyle for the majority of people, what your plan shows is that that bell-shaped curve is inverted and we end up having goalposts. So there's a whole lot of very rich and wealthy people who come out of this plan and a whole lot of very poor people. So my question is, like, how is it we have so many people and so much of our money going into working on a transportation and housing plan, which by your own conclusions diminishes and violates what is such a strong characteristic of strong American values as the middle class?
Well, I think the first thing I would say to that is, in terms of the crisis that's facing the middle class and the gap between rich and poor, I think the plan is trying to point that out in abundant fashion. I think the question is, where do we sort of ascribe the blame for that? This is a problem. This is sort of how we think about the last presidential election in a lot of ways. This is things that are national trends that are going on. And we're seeing that in this region as well. When it comes to the plan's performance, I think it's always important to look at how the plan performs relative to no plan at all. So that's also an important piece of this that we need to think about. When we look at that relative performance, and when we look at issues like housing and transportation costs, displacement risk, and things like that, the plan does perform better than no plan. So we are making some progress in that direction. As I think we're limited in terms of the resources that we have, and we can't do everything in this plan to solve these problems, many of which are just problems that are happening outside of the national level in this country. And I think that's also what's motivated our commission to ask that question of, well, what will it take? If this plan is making H plus T affordability worse for lower income families, and if that's the trajectory that we're seeing out to 2040, with or without a plan, what can we do? How can we motivate more affordability in this region? Do we need, what are the policies that we need on the local level? So those are some of the things that we're trying to figure out. But I agree with you with the middle class question from an overall standpoint.
Can I add something to that question? So I think the numbers you're referring to are at the regional level doing the forecast. So when we do the forecast, we didn't really, so it's the first step of making the plan. By doing the forecast, we were doing in terms of the historical trend and what's happening in the economy. And then we have this plan to really talk about how we address the issues you just raised.
Before we take the next question, if I might, I think sometimes it's helpful to get up to the 35,000 foot level when we look at these problems. And if you look at the entire West Coast from San Diego to Seattle, you will see that there is a similar problem with the hollowing out of the middle class. The pressures on the coastal areas all up and down the West Coast and the transportation challenges, they're the same up and down the West Coast of the United States and elsewhere. And so I don't think we can say Plan Bay Area is the cause of the hollowing out. I think we're seeing this in the western part of the U.S. just because of the way our geography and our development patterns have grown. So I just want to throw that in there. And it also says to us, let's look at other places who have these same problems and work together on solutions. So.